Hey guys, Punk here once again. Let's see. Getting ready to go face the gym leader. I got my baby cam up and running, so I'm not the static that I was for the reps. So that's a good thing. Alright, since it's pretty late, let's go try and catch a Spinarak or two. Basically, nothing but a stat reducer. It's gonna have all of the poison powder, sleep powder, and all that good shit, plus confusion. So, it should be a better piece than being. As you can see, I haven't played since I made the last video, so there's nothing different. In case this is the first video you're watching, this is my bug Pokemon only challenge for Pokemon Gold. Here's a Spinarak. I don't know if I'm gonna one hit KO these guys or not with tackle. Let's see. Hopefully not. Nope. Okay. Looks like it'll be able to take two hits. I'm not positive on that, but oof. See? These guys will be good. Let's see now. Do not faint. There we go. It's close. That's good. Bug Freeze is going to be excellent. Not Bug Freeze. Oh no! I forgot to get more Pokeballs because I completely forgot that I could catch more Bug Pokeball. Alright, well, let's. You fucker. Let's try and make it down real quick. And heal up Butterfree. Grab a couple of Pokeballs while we're at it. We want any of our Butterfree to faint. We're not doing like a Nuzlocke challenge where if they die, that's it, they're dead. But, or if they faint, that's it, they're dead. But I'll probably do that later with one of the newer Pokemon games, so that way it'll look a bit better. And since this is Gold and Silver, I am planning on taking out the Elite Four with nothing but Bug Pokemon, and then going to Kanto, and just trying to wreck the shit out of all the original gym leaders and the improved Pokemon. Five Pokemon should be enough for quite a while. There are really, really few Bug Pokemon that you can catch in these games. It's super low amount. I'm not even catching anything but Bug Pokemon. So this is gonna be. Let's double check the Pokedex and see if Spinarak's in the next area or if he's got to be further down. Looks like he's in this area right up here too. Yeah, he's right in this next area, so I don't have to go all the way down there. I can just go right here and search for Spinarak. Hopefully catch a couple of them. Let's see, there's a Hoo-Hoo. Not what I want. I'm gonna have to, later at least, grab a Pokemon for Fly, because when I do grab one, I'm literally going to teach it Fly, throw it in my Pokemon box, and then just pull it out when I need to Fly, then throw it back in. My flying Pokemon's never going to see battle, not even once. Try and keep it near. My completely bug Pokemon, if any of them could learn Fly. Even though they've got wings, specifically Scyther. I mean, Scyther looks like it could carry around, but for some reason Game Freak decided that Scyther can't learn Fly, so. Let's see if this one's going to be able to teach it soon. Oh, you fainted. Damn it. Alright, gonna have to keep searching for Spinarak. I wanna get at least two or three. Probably two. Because Spinarak's pretty alright, but he's not. It's not, like, the greatest part of Pokemon. Oh, I just used Confusion. It's so super stupid. Customize this Butterfree for Pokemon catching purposes. It'll be weaker than the first. Just so that way that doesn't happen again, because I'm sure it would otherwise. So I'll pay enough attention to it. Alright, Spinarak, here we go. Let's do this. Let's get just a female Spinarak. My king is female already, so. You fucker. Of course, Butterfree's poison. Let's do a Pokemon and cross our fingers. Come on. Stay in your hall. You slut. I don't have anything weaker than this Butterfree, so. Let's just keep throwing Pokeballs and cross our fingers. Come on, come on. Yeah, you're mine. Yes. Perfect. Lies still in the same pose for days in its web, waiting for its unsuspecting prey to wander close. Let's see. I was gonna put in arachnophobia, but it looks like arachnophobia is gonna have to work. Let's go pack here. Bye-bye poison. Hello to another Spinarak, hopefully. We'll catch at least two. This Butterfree is probably gonna gain another level before I can fight the gym, so that's good. Bug Pokemon aren't my favorite type or anything, I just thought this would be more challenging than, you know, just running through with whatever Pokemon that I wanted. I'm also gonna do a Pokemon, most likely Pokemon red or blue, I'm not sure which, but one of the two, doing a normal type only challenge, which will be super fun. They're by far not the strongest type, but they have the biggest new tools, making my red blues and just about any type, so it should be balanced. It won't be super hard, but it's going to be normal and flying, because you don't get any normal types before Brock, except I think Pidgey and Spearow. Oh, and Rattata. But, you know, I want to have the access to the Pokemon. They're going to have little to no flying moves anyways, so I figure it's not too bad. I'll probably do Fire Red instead of just red, so that way it'll look better. It won't have these 8-bit graphics. I'm pretty sure this entire episode is just going to consist of me talking and being in search of Spinarak. Searching for Spinarak. Then I'll end the episode and I'll go train up a bit. Get Spinarak. think males generally have higher defense. Easiest way to do this is just go stats. Okay, so it's got 17 for an attack stat. This one here's got 16. Alright, second to last one. I think it's this one has the lowest attack stat. Yes. Switch this one out, and hopefully the one lower, well, the lower attack stat will make it so it doesn't knock out the Spinarak. Let's see. Ah, it didn't. Spinarak's encounter rate is like 25%, so one in four battles I should be a Spinarak, 20 to 25%, something like that. I'm not positive on the figures, so just thinking maybe that's what it is, but positive. It might be something as low as like 5 to 10% for most possible. Once again, what I'm really looking forward to getting for my team is a pine cup. What? I didn't think Bellsprout appeared down here. Super awesome, I love the idea of going back to the Kanto region once you're done with the Johto region, finding out how everybody else is done. You know, it's a cool idea. I would love to have that Spinarak. That would be just the best. Come on, Spinarak. You're definitely a Spinarak. Grassy Gamers. should catch it. Yes! Spinarak! Alright. Direct name is Spinarak. Salvador. Alright. I'm just gonna head back into town, grab these guys, and then I'm gonna end the video. So, actually, I'll just end the video on my way there. So, yeah, this is. Ah, you son of a bitch. This has been fun, and, yeah, it's been fun. I'm gonna go grab this Spinarak, train him up a bit, figure out which Butterfree to get rid of. See how it goes. Once again, this has been Plunk, and I will see you guys later.